your fat away? Well, I know these three letters haunt you every day. F-A-T. But say goodbye to them, because for the next 30 minutes, we're reducing these letters down to nothing. I'm going to reveal the three most promising fat melters. Whether you want to lose fat without diet or exercise, stop the excess fat from piling on, or just lose those last stubborn 5 pounds, this is the show for you. Let's get started. I've got Dr. Eva Selhub joining us. She's a leading expert in the field of weight loss. Thanks for joining us. So this concept of fat melting, describe what that is as a physician.
Well, I actually like to think of it as you're putting a fat on a frying pan, right? You turn on the fire, creates heat. What happens to the fat? It melts. Well, the same thing happens in our bodies. So what happens is those fat cells are broken down. We call it lipolysis, lipofat lysis breakdown. That lipolysis makes energy. Energy creates heat, or thermogenesis, thermoheat, genesis, creation. That heat, guess what it does to the fat?
Melts the fat.
Exactly. That's why exercise works. You see, so exercise creates that energy, creates that heat, it melts the fat. But now we know there's some natural ways for that to happen without having to move. I don't advocate not moving, but we know that it can happen without moving.
And it is a challenge, I think, to melt the fat for a lot of folks. But today we've got some ideas that are really going to help out.
Fair enough.
And the last fat melter, one of my favorites. This will help you lose those last stubborn 5 pounds. And one of the beauties of this is that you can actually get this pretty readily in your diet. It's called MCT, or medium chain triglycerides. So what is this, Dr. Selhub, and how does it work?
Well, this is one of my favorites because you can bring it into a healthy lifestyle. And so medium chain triglycerides, as the name implies, is they're medium sized versus long chain triglycerides, which are pretty much almost all the fats that we eat. And because they're smaller, they're easier to digest. So it goes right into the stomach, right to the liver, and it gets broken down for fuel.
This is such an important principle that I want to demonstrate it with this little model. So this is the blood going through the body. When you eat foods that have medium-chain triglycerides, the body immediately absorbs that into the liver. And because it goes to the liver, it's broken down as energy rapidly, easily dissolved. That's why places in the world that have lots of these MCTs in their diet naturally don't seem to have as much of an issue as we do.
Right.
Now, fats, on the other hand, are very different. Because fats, because they have these long, bulky chains, they're thick and they're cumbersome. They can't get through the system, so they have to go into the lymph. When they get into your lymph, they clump up. And you see how this is forming this sort of thick material here?
Yeah.
I mean, it really pulls everything together, and it doesn't actually get absorbed the way you want it to. And because of that, it tends to get deposited, as you mentioned, Dr. Selhub, in very unsightly places, the places you don't want it to be. So what kind of results could you rationally expect to have if you could start taking the recommended amount of MCT?
Well, the studies show, this is pretty cool stuff, but you can actually burn about 100 calories a day by adding MCT to your diet. That's 3,000 calories a month. That's a pound of fat a month. That's pretty significant, yeah, just by adding it to your diet, adding it to your lifestyle.
So one of our viewers, Andrea, she's from Arkansas, she sent us before and after images. She said she used MCT and lost 100 pounds. This picture will blow you away. And Andrea is just appearing from us. So what form do you suggest? Is this best in a pill form, in a food form?
Yes.
Yes,
well, you know, it's naturally found in coconut oil. I personally use coconut oil only for my baking, and then I'll use sometimes olive oil and a lot of coconut oil for cooking. Mm-hmm. So you can just bring it into your diet. And the other way is by taking an MCT oil about 10 to 20 grams a day.
So 2 tablespoons of coconut oil basically means you can replace the butter you might use for your eggs in the morning and baking product. Just replace it one for one. And if you do that, you get this. See? You avoid this. This is what happens to those large fats, the ones you get from butter and other sources that we have in our diet in America. If you can get rid of this in your diet and take the MCT versions, the coconut oil, you can avoid this clumping up on your hips, your thighs, and all those other unsightly places you always complain about.